head cheese. Despite its name, there is no cheese in head cheese. It is actually a cold, savory jelly that is usually made with the meat from a pig's or calf's head. It was first created in Europe hundreds of years ago. Back then, the wealthy people got all the good meat, so poorer people had to be creative with what was left. These days, head cheese is less common, but it can still be found in countries from Scotland to Spain.
我们来看看第三种名字听起来很奇怪的食物是 head cheese, 猪头肉冻。说到头 ,Mike 老师有用到 skull 这个字 ,S-K-U-L-L, skull 就是指颅骨、头盖骨。好，那虽然这个食物叫做 head cheese, 但是里头却没有 cheese, 它其实是一种冰冷咸味的胶状物，那通常是用猪头或者是小牛头的肉制成的。它起初是在好几百年前的欧洲创造出来，那当时有钱人可以取得所有好的肉，好的部分都被他们拿走，那穷人家就得发挥创意来料理剩下的东西了。而如今猪头肉冻比较少见了，但是从这个苏格兰到西班牙等等国家还是可以找到。这让 Mike 老师想到另外一种食物是 Patty， 就是肉酱，它是把肉啊鱼等等剁碎然后加上佐料制成的食品。好，那么课文单字 wealthy 它是形容富裕的、有钱的，那么 creative 则是形容有创意的、有创造力的。
Ants on a log. Ants on a log isn't as scary as it sounds. It's simply a celery stick, the log, that is cut in half, filled with peanut butter, and dotted with raisins, the ants. It's an easy snack for kids to make and enjoy.Plus, there are lots of ways to change it, like switching the raisins for other dried fruits, nuts, or chocolate chips. So, when you're feeling hungry, why not fill up on some ants or babies? Don't tell anybody, though, as they might think you've gone crazy.
最后要介绍的食物是 Ant on a log, 原木上的蚂蚁。它并不像听起来那么可怕，其实就只是一根切半的芹菜条，然后里面填满了花生酱，再撒上葡萄干来点缀。所以呢，原木就是指芹菜，蚂蚁就是指葡萄干。那这对孩子来说是一道容易做又好吃的零食。它也有很多变化形式，像是把这个葡萄干换成其他干果、坚果或者是巧克力碎片。好，来看单字 scary。scary 是形容可怕的、恐怖的。switch 这个动词则表示转换、改变或者是调换。Sam 老师提到 switch 也可以当名词来指开关、电器开关，像我们可以用 light switch 来指电灯开关。老师们最后也有提到一些奇怪名字的食物，像是 pigs in a blanket 猪包毯，它可能是这种用培根去裹香肠，或者是热狗面包卷。那这时候 Sam 老师有提到 crescent roll 就是指奶油面包卷，而 Mike 老师则提到 lady fingers 则是指手指饼干。好，那这边两个重点，我们进入文法时间。好，我们来看第一个重点是 as 形容词 as 或者是 as 副词 as 点点点，这是表达和什么一样怎么样，那这是形容词或副词原级比较的句型。第二个 as 后面可以接子句，当子句的动词跟前面相同的话，可以把它省略掉或者是用助动词来代替。我们来看两个例句， Molly is as tall as her sister is 或者是 Molly is as tall as her sister， Molly 和她的姐姐一样高。I don't drink coffee as often as Tim does, 或者是 I don't drink coffee as often as Tim, 我不像 Tim 一样常喝咖啡。那第二个重点是动词 fill 的用法。第一个我们可以用来指填满、装满，常常用被动 be filled with something 去表达充满某事物，像 the basket is filled with fresh fruit， 篮子有满满的新鲜水果。那第二个可以用 fill 去表达使某人吃饱喝足，当这个意思解释时常会接 up， 那它可以当及物或不及物用，像是 the pizza isn't big enough to fill them up， 那个 pizza 不够大，没办法让他们吃饱。补充一下， fill up on something 则是表达吃什么直到饱足为止，像是 the boys filled up on fried chicken and mashed potatoes， 男孩们吃了炸鸡和马铃薯泥填饱肚子。